Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage Manhattan Transfer.
Love will be, and I really, I think it's been wonderful. The audiences are very, very enthusiastic. Very enthusiastic. Like, you saw the show tonight. They've all been like that. And I think the hardest show is always the first one, because we hadn't played in about 2 or 3 weeks since we, you know, over the holiday season and all that. And so the first show, you got to get, you know, warmed up. It was okay, but after that, it was wonderful. You know, we've been coming to Japan a long time, and obviously, you know, it's a culture that's much different from America. And I think for myself, I felt a little out of place the first few years that I started coming, because I was still learning a lot about Japan, and I wasn't sure about people's behavior or what they mean. But I found inside, and not here, but in here, that as the years went on, I found myself, when I think about it at home, but I'd feel it here, I always find, I would think about it, gosh, you know, I feel so comfortable when I come to Japan. You know, I was started to realize I was feeling so comfortable when I'd come over, and I think it was because I was really starting to understand a lot more about the country and getting to know it. And now, after a while, I miss it when I'm home. I always look forward to coming here. I do. It's always a very, very nice experience.
And it's called Bahía de Todos los Cantos.
Da 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 da
Janis, I think, is very much like me on a musical level. You know, I think she's very, very serious about her involvement with jazz, and I was very serious with my involvement with jazz, swing and rhythm and blues. And I think that we were both very, very, you know, we took a large role in forming the musical structure of the group. Alan is a very theatrical person, totally different than us. He comes in from a much more visual kind of perspective. As an individual, he's very much influenced by television when he was a kid and the comedic aspect of television. He has a great sense of humor, but he loves to portray characters and that sort of thing. Cheryl is very much like Alan in that regard, but not so much because of her influence on television, but I think her love of theater. In a lot of ways, I think she's the best performer on stage. I think she really has great, great stage presence. She really does. I think we try to keep it a democracy. I don't think any one person is really allowed to go out and make major decisions without discussing it. We try to discuss everything. We try to be very communicative with each other and so that everyone's involved with all the main decisions. So we just try to, you know, have a good organization and try to have good people. We have a lot of great people with us. That's what's really important. And just try to keep it organized. So, communication is very, very important in any relationship.
Let's take a little drive, shall you?
If you ever plan to Motorwest, travel my way, take that highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66.
It winds from Chicago to LA. It's more than 2,000 miles on.
Sorry.
Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty.
Yes, you'll see Amarillo. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Tim Hauser.
Thank you.
Okay, here's a song that comes from Miss Ella Fitzgerald. This is the very first tune that she recorded with the Chick Webb Band. It goes like this.
Peck, 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 and all her hollow bones. When she spied it on the ground,
she took
basket. I lost my yellow basket.
It's a good question. It's like being married to three people for, in a way, for such a long time. I think that I'll just speak for myself. I think that the band as a whole is much larger than me as a person, and I feel very grateful to be a part of something that's very, very special. I remember when we first started, at our very first rehearsal, when the arrangement was written out, just a little piece about maybe four bars, and the first time we all sang together, and the sound was so, we all looked at each other, we started laughing, because it was really beautiful sound. And I think for myself, that's what I really enjoy, is I enjoy hearing it as I'm doing it. I enjoy the energy, but I enjoy hearing it. And for me, that's why, because I still enjoy it. Well, it always changes. You know, it is essentially the same. I mean, it's a band that was put together to explore singing in four-part harmony, not three-part. Three-part harmony is like Motown, doo-wop, gospel music, blues, you know. And then, but there were a lot of groups in the 60s that sang four-part, but they didn't have a blues or rhythm and blues influence. But we've combined all that kind of stuff. So in essence, it is what it is, but it's always changing in terms of where we take it. Like now, we're working on, we're going to do the music of Chick Corea. That's our newest album. And that's going to be a real adventure. That's something really unusual for us. But what we're bringing to it is the same band, the same idea of four-part harmony, but it's a really different avenue to do his music. So that's going to change us in a way.
Boop-bop-boop-bop.
place where people go to dance and lie away. They all drive or walk or miles to get blues. That silence drives your room. It'll make you want to dance the night away. Cross intersections where I wanna be.
Thank you.
My personal feeling about that is that we're professional. And if I'm feeling tired about something, I have to understand that the audience, people that come to see us, they're coming to hear those tunes. And that's how I am. When I go and see, you know, bands, my favorite bands, if I go and see them and they play all new stuff, they don't play the stuff I like, I feel disappointed. But we don't have to be completely like that, because in a concert we'll do like maybe 21 songs. So maybe we'll include like maybe 7 or 8 that we know we've got to do. And then maybe there's a whole bunch of other tunes that are from different albums and things that we can do. And maybe some of those things we can do to satisfy ourselves. So you try to keep a nice balance, but you know that you have to, you know there are certain songs that people are going to want to hear. I call it the zen of performing. If I think about things, I'm not performing. But it happens. You go in and out. We talk about, all performers talk about it. You snap in and out. You sing and you find yourself, you start thinking about something else while you're singing. You go, oh, and you jump back in. I mean, the ideal situation is to never think. You know, with some of these songs that we do, there's a lot of words. And the solos, you know, there's a fear that you're going to forget the words. So when it comes up to that point in the solo, the only way to do it is to not think. Because you know it. It's already there. You know that. And that's like the zen of performing.
Down in Yes, indeed he did.
Yes, indeed he did.
Yes, indeed he did.
Come from Bladenburg.
Oh, yes, yes, yes,
yes, yes, yes, he really did.
Yes, indeed
he took the tube way down in Bladenburg.
Yes, indeed he did. God would find the Bladenburg land.
Yes, indeed he really did.
Choo-choo!